Good morning to everybody. So already we learned what is meant by congruent. If two figures are congruent, then can we say that areas of the two figures are equal? Do you have any idea what I am asking you? If two figures are congruent, then shall we conclude that areas of the two figures are equal? Okay. First to take like it's a rectangle ABCD. It's a rectangle ABCD. Its side, it's 8 cm, it's 2 cm. What? ABCD is a rectangle in which two adjacent sides are 8 cm and 2 cm. Then area, what is the area of the rectangle ABCD? Area of rectangle ABCD. Area of rectangle ABCD means what? Product of the adjacent side. What is the product of the adjacent side? 8 cm into 2 cm, which is equal to 16 cm square. Am I right? What is the area of the rectangle? Product of the two adjacent side. Then product of the two adjacent side is what? 16 cm square. Then consider a square. Consider a square with side 4 cm. Here PQRS is a square whose side is what? 4 cm. Then what is the area of a square now? Area of a square PQRS, that is equal to side into side. What is the side here? 4 cm. So 4 cm into 4 cm, 16 cm square. Am I right? So clearly we can say that these two figures are not a congruent because all the corresponding angles are equal, but the sides are what? Not equal. The sides are what? Not equal. So these two triangles are not congruent, but these areas of these two figures are what? Equal. Are you getting there? So if the areas of the two figures are equal, it need not to be congruent to each other. It need not to be congruent to each other. If suppose, if the two figures are congruent, then obviously, then areas of the two figures are equal. Areas of the two figures are equal. For example, you can take like, it's a right angle triangle, I am saying like, okay, 6, 36, 64, 100, yes, it is a triangle ABC you can take, another triangle PQR you can take, PQR, it is 6 cm, it is 8 cm, it is 10 cm, it's 90 degree, 90 degree, 90 degree, am I right? These two triangles are congruent. How these two triangles are congruent? In this triangle ABC, it is 6 cm. It is 8 cm. It is 10 cm. Then again, in another triangle, angle Q is what? 90 degree. Then QP is what? 6 cm. And QR is 8 cm, then RP is 10 cm. Am I right? So what you can say? You can say SAS or SSS or ASA, you can't say. SSS you can say SAS, RHS. Okay. So by any one of these congruence criteria, we can conclude that these two triangles are congruent. These two triangles are congruent. Now, shall we find the area of the triangle ABC now? Find the area of triangle ABC, that is half into base into height. Half into base is what? 6 cm. And height is what? 8 cm. That is a perpendicular. 2, 4, 6, 4 are 24 cm². Similarly, find the area of triangle QRP now. Area of triangle QPR, that means half into base. Base is what? QP is 6. height is what? 8 cm. So 3 8s are 24 cm square. Now already here we proved that these two triangles are congruent. Am I right? At the same time we are getting the areas of these two triangles are also equal. So what can we conclude? If the two triangles are congruent, then the areas of the two triangles are what? Equal. Not only for triangle, quadrilateral also. Any n-sided polygon. Okay. If the two figures are congruent to each other, then the areas of the two figures are also equal. Are you getting there? But that converse part is not true. That means if the areas of the two figures are equal, then it need not to be the congruence to each other. It need not to be congruence to each other. Then after that, here in this chapter, in areas of parallelograms and triangle, so we are going to learn some theorem. That is, if two parallelograms, are on the same base, and between the same parallel, then areas of two parallelograms are equal. Then they are equal in area. Are you getting here? That means it's a parallelogram ABCD. It's another parallelogram AB, PQ you can take. ABCD is a parallelogram. AB, PQ is also a parallelogram. These are the two parallelograms. Are on the same base, AB, and between the same parallel, DP. Then the areas of the two parallelograms are equal in area. The tomorrow I will give the proof for this. And then similarly, if a triangle and a parallelogram are on the same base and between the same parallel, then the area of the triangle is equal to half of the areas of the parallelogram. The tomorrow I will give you the proof of the same. Thank you, everybody. Thank you.